Welcome to r/IDOWorkHereLady, where we share stories about employees that are mistaken for customers. And the first story is, yes, I am old enough to drive, and yes, I work here. So, a little background. I am a little person. I have a mild form of hypopituitary dwarfism, which means I am all of 4'9 and 90 pounds. For about 5 years, I worked at a university, after finishing my undergrad while I went to grad school. I worked with hearing-impaired students, assisting them with stuff in the classroom. I also did transcribing and live closed captioning for their lectures live so they could take notes. It was a pretty sweet gig if you like learning. Get paid to go to classes. And we were the only university that offered this kind of service for hearing-impaired people when I started. The one drawback was I had to lug around a lot of equipment, including a laptop and microphone. So I made use of the handicap parking I have. The kind of dwarfism I have causes all kinds of weird joint stuff, so that I can park relatively close to the kids' classes on the sprawling campuses I worked on. This day it was really nasty weather, sleeting and cold, but I had snagged a prime parking spot right in the middle of campus, just behind the building my student had class in. I had about 45 minutes before my student's class started, so I opened my laptop to go over the transcript and correct any mistakes before I sent it on to the student. So I was just sitting in my car working, while I waited, when I hear an annoyed knocking on my window. I look up and see a grumpy old man. We'll just call him G-O-M. My window on that side didn't roll down, so I crack my door. Me, can I help you? Grumpy old man, are you a student? Me, I am, but I also work here. Do you need something? At this point, I thought maybe he was lost. Campus can be a bit confusing, and after almost 9 years there at that point, between my own education and work, I was used to giving directions. Grumpy old man, I don't think you're a student. Let me see your ID. Me, I don't think so. There's no reason for you to see that. If you don't need anything, I have to get ready for work. Grumpy old man, you can't park here if you're not a student. You need to move. Me, I work here and I am a student. You can see my parking pass in the window and my handicap tag. I try to close my door at this point, but he won't move his hand, which is on the top of the door. I'm also getting nervous, because I'm tiny, and while he is old, he's still bigger than me. Grumpy old man, if you're a student, show me your ID. Me, not gonna happen. If you wanna walk to the other side, you can see my pass in the window to park. Otherwise, call and report me if you don't believe me, but I have stuff to do. I jerked my door closed then, making him lose his grip, and made sure they were locked. He stood there for a minute or two glaring at me. I ignored him and went back to working on my laptop, while I waited for it to be class time for my student. He glared at me for a bit, then stomped back to his car and left. About 15 minutes after this, just before I was heading to class with my student, my cell rang. It was one of our parking enforcement officers I was friends with. The old jerk had actually called and reported a little girl in handicapped parking, who didn't look old enough to drive, let alone be a student, saying that she worked there, and they needed to come out and make me move. I was in my mid-20s at this point. We shared a good laugh. She said she knew as soon as he made the report it was me. She asked me if I was okay, if he was still bothering me. Luckily, he hadn't come back, so I said I was fine, but told her how he acted. She said they had his info and would keep an eye out in case he harassed anyone else. The second story is, I do work here, and your vacation is over. Quite a few years ago, I worked as a ski school supervisor at a mountain resort. One day early in the season, it's slow, so I decided to take a run with one of my coworkers. Since I've been on my skis a lot, I opt to grab my snowboard for this particular jaunt. This is important later. So me and my buddy are out and about for a couple of runs, and it's time to head back in to check for lessons. We're down off the main mountain and just cruising along a green, easy run that leads back to the base area. Like I said, it's a slow day, so there's nobody around. Or so I think. I'm making regular, smooth turns on my board when out of nowhere I hear a woman from behind me screech, "Get out of the way! Get out of the way!" Before I can even flinch, I feel something hit the tail of my board. I get spun around and go down kinda hard. For a moment, the red rage light blinks in my head, but I think, okay, we're in a beginner area. She might not have had control. It was an accident, be cool. I pull myself up off the snow and calm myself down. I look down the hill, and there are two Karens standing about 50 yards downhill. Obviously, one of them was the one that hit me. Cool, they've stopped to make sure I'm okay and apologize. I slide down to them and open my mouth to check if they're okay. Before I can even get one word out of my mouth, Karen 1 starts screaming at me. What the F do you think you're doing? You could have killed me. You effing snowboarders are a menace. You don't belong on the mountain. And on it goes, screaming at me, cursing at me, calling me all sorts of names. One important note, there are a set of rules that govern skiing, and one of them is that skiers and riders ahead of you have the right of way. Just like driving, if you hit someone from behind while skiing, you are 100% at fault. I try to interrupt politely to tell her this, but Karen is having none of it. At this point I'm thinking, okay, F you Karen, I'm tearing you a new a-hole once you're finished yelling. I look over at my buddy for backup, and suddenly my rage-filled brain realizes something. My buddy is in full uniform. I look down. Black pants, blue and gray jacket with the resort logo on front and back, bright shiny gold name tag that says supervisor under my name, and a radio mic clipped to my collar. Yeah, I'm in full uniform too. At this point, I'm dumbfounded. Is this woman seriously screaming and cursing at two mountain employees after she just caused a crash? What? Then I get calm and hold out my hand for her to stop. I have no idea why, but Karen stops screaming. I reach up to the radio mic and call ski patrol. I ask them to have the patrol director on duty meet me at the base area. It's at this point that it finally dawns on Karen that she is effed up. She starts asking why I called patrol and what I'm going to do. I just shrug. She starts saying she doesn't want me following her and to leave her alone. Again, we're almost inside of the base. There's nowhere else to go other than to follow this trail down. She realizes she's stuck and skis down with her friend. Her friend at this point looks mortified, by the way. We get to the base and the patrol director is standing there with another patroller. I give a recap of the events, including some of the graphic things she told me to do to myself and multiple family members. The patrol director rolls his eyes, then pulls out wire cutters. Karen goes wide-eyed and is like, "No, you can't take my ticket. It's a 5-day ticket. We just got here today. This is our vacation." Tickets are over $75 per day, so we're talking like a $350 ticket this lady has on. The patrol director just shrugs and says, "Well, ma'am, then you just made a very expensive mistake," and clips the ticket. At that point, my coworker and I beat a retreat back to the ski school because we want no part of the fallout. The next story is, you'd think this happened more often. A couple of short ones, as it's my first time posting. Please excuse my grammar, I'm on my phone. A little background, I work in a fairly popular cocktail bar and have for about 1.5 years. So it comes to a surprise to me that this hasn't happened more often. My uniform is fairly casual, blue or black jeans with either a printed t-shirt with our work logo on it or a branded alcohol brewery t-shirt. We have lots of different ones to promote the stock we sell. We also usually carry a tea towel and bar blade in our pockets that are clearly visible. I'm also the most easily recognizable staff member, as I'm the only one with blue hair and facial piercings. The first time I had this I Don't Work Here Lady issue was after I became a proper bartender. I was just doing my rounds on a Saturday night, our busiest night of the week, and it was getting close to Christmas last year, so we were packed. I was going between serving people at the bar and doing sweeps of the floor for empty glasses. Part of the floor means going into the ladies' bathroom and checking stock for hand towels and such. On this particular night, it was busy enough that there was a line out of the bathrooms, and the hallway leading to them is only wide enough for two people to fit. Now, for reference, me is self-explanatory, RDG is rude drunk girl, NDG is nicer drunk girl. During one of my floor runs, I went to check on the ladies' bathroom to see if everything was in order. We have no female security guards, so female staff have to routinely check to make sure nothing is broken, left behind, vomited on, etc. Despite the line of girls, I walked straight past, not dressed anything like these girls, as I was in uniform, when from directly behind me, rude drunk girl screamed from the middle of the line. Rude drunk girl, "B, there's a line!" Me, "I'm sorry, I'm just checking the toilets, I work here." Rude drunk girl, "No you don't, you're just using that as an excuse to cut in line." Me, "Look, I'm really sorry, but you don't seem to understand. I'm just here to make sure you girls have hand towels and such." At this point, I turned away and continued to the bathroom, as I heard the nicer drunk girl, who must have been her friend, say, "Calm down, she works here. Can't you see her uniform?" On the way back out, the rude drunk girl just quietly said thank you, and that was the end of it. The second time I encountered someone like this, I was rostered on for glassy work, just working the floor. Again, it was a Saturday and super busy, so we were at capacity for the venue. Now, when you're trying to move around in a venue with 300 people in it, who are drunk and dancing, it can be a real task getting around people to do your job. Our bar has tables stationed around the floor for people to sit at and such, and so there are a lot of times when the only way to get from one side of the venue to the other is by moving through tightly packed spaces. At some point during this night, I had only picked up maybe one or two glasses on my round, and was en route to another that I had spotted on a nearby table. Trying to move past someone, I got bumped into by a customer, and was very suddenly knocked into another. Remember, it's a super cramped space, and there's people everywhere, so it's impossible to move without touching someone. Turns out the man I was knocked into was with a girl, drunk and somewhere between 18 to 25 years old, who saw part of what had happened, and assumed that I had purposely pushed her drinking partner. The conversation is as follows. Rude drunk girl pushes me from behind, so I turn around. "Don't push people!" Me, confused and already in a bad mood from a rough shift. "You literally just pushed me!" Rude drunk girl. "I don't care, it's rude to push people. You should be kicked out." Me, "They won't kick me out, I work." Rude drunk girl, "You're such a B, I'm gonna make sure you get banned from coming here." Me, "You can sure as heck try, I work here, so if you don't shut your trap, I'll get my friends over there," gestures to the security guards by the door, "to kick your A out. Now leave me alone, I'm trying to do my job." The look on her face was priceless. The last story is, yes, I know which teacher assistant. When I was 25 to 27, I was a teacher assistant at university. I'm not sure if these stories completely fit here, but it's pretty close in concept, so I'd like to post them anyway. There are also more small anecdotes with low conflict, but anyway, being a teacher's assistant in the mathematics groups meant that the professor teaches the actual lectures in the morning, but I supervise the exercise sessions in the afternoon. During these, the students must solve a list of math problems. I help them when needed, solve some on the blackboard. The students in my group are always first-year students, aka 18-year-olds mostly. It should be noted that I look very young. Despite the age of 25 plus and having some facial hair, I can be mistaken for an 18-year-old. If I'd shave the facial hair, I might be mistaken for a tall minor. When I meet a new group for the first time, they usually think upon seeing me that I am a fellow student of them, until I start writing on the blackboard naturally. There are two stories that stand out a bit more, however. 1. I was on my way to the first session with a new group, somewhere in a complex of buildings I hadn't been myself before. Didn't even know which building my room was. Wanting to speed up the search, I asked a random person if he knew where classroom was. Turns out the young man was one of my students, also searching that room. We found it together, it being this big auditorium-style classroom. Upon entering, he gestured to a row somewhere in the middle, and thinking I was a fellow classmate asked, "Wanna go sit over there?" To which I replied, "No man, I'll be going all the way to the front." I started walking, and when looking back, I saw the young man having this sad, rejected look on his face. He probably thought I only considered him good enough to find my way, but not to associate with any further than that. It was the beginning of the year, so he probably didn't know any actual classmates yet. When I went all the way to the teacher desk in front, took out my notes and took some chalk ready, I had another quick glance back at him. He was still standing at the same place, but his expression changed to a rather shocked one, as if thinking, "OSH, I just asked the teacher's assistant to sit with me." He was rather silent that session. 2. Second story with a different group, hadn't had them in a while due to insert boring scheduling reasons here. I was at the room about 10 minutes before the start, but had to wait outside, as a previous lecture was still going on. One student also showed up early, waiting with me. She kept to herself at first, until she turned to me and genuinely asked, "Do you know which teacher assistant we have today?" I paused for a moment, grinned, and replied, "Ah yes, I do know that." She looked at me questioningly, while I paused for another moment, then pointed at myself with a rather exaggerated arm flourish, and said that would be me. Her eyes went wide, and she just stumbling replied, yes, thanks." She was also very silent that session. Thinking back, I wished I said something else, that I pretended being a fellow student for a bit, and replied something like, "Yeah, it's this my name guy. He means well, but he's weird and not so bright in my opinion." Then watch a reaction when I start the session and introduce myself. Could have been more amusing. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.